Greetings. Today we will be looking at how you can make your renders faster in the DAW Studio. We will see which settings should you use and how much faster it would be. I will be using this simple scene with all free assets and 3 lights. All settings set to default, except max samples is 500 for faster renders for the video. Let's render and see the result. Render is ready and everything looking good. Though it does not say how long did it take. But worry not, because there is an easy way to check rendering times. To do that, go to the Help, Troubleshooting, View Log File. Scroll to the very bottom and find the total rendering time. For me, this render took 4 minutes and 49 seconds. Let's see how we can make this number much smaller using different techniques. First thing that you need to make sure before proceeding is to check whether you are using your GPU. It is done in the Advanced tab of the Render Settings. Here you can see devices that you are using for renders. Double check that your graphics card, GPU, is enabled in both modes. It is important, because GPU tend to be much better than CPUs for rendering. And it can be even more useful if you turn on both of them at the same time. Sadly, if you have an AMD GPU, you probably won't see it here. Iray is an NVIDIA technology, so only NVIDIA GPUs can render with it. Now let's return to the editor in the render settings and talk more about what we can change here to improve times. For example, in the render mode we can change what mode to use while rendering. We can change from the default photoreal mode to the interactive. It is biased and overall worse than photoreal mode, but can be faster. You can see that the skin looks a lot different, it is almost red in the interactive render. Additionally, there is a definite lack of shadows. What is the most sad part is that it was not even faster in my case. Instead, it was almost 10 seconds longer. Maybe it is just my scene or computer, so you should try this one for yourself. Another way to render fast is Filament. It is another rendering engine, independent of the Iray. Though it can use Iray materials as we see right now on the screen. It is a real-time rendering engine, which means that it is as fast as your screen refresh basically. Though it is a lot worse than Iray. Lighting is very flat, spotlights don't work at all, only environmental lighting. There are even no shadows. You can improve on this a bit by using the Filament Draw Options node from the Create menu. Or by finding products on the DAWs3D.com shop. To render with Filament you need to change the engine to the viewport, as Filament is a viewport renderer. Filament is mostly useful as a quick preview engine. So if you want to check something without rendering it in Iray, it is the way to go. Also, it can be used for simple and fast animations. But it is not a good fit for a quality image render. A pretty obvious way to change your rendering time is to change resolution. This is done in the General tab of Rendering Settings. Pixel size is your resolution. It has a width and height options. There is also a lot of dimension presets available here. For example, one of the most popular resolutions, Full HD. Higher you set your resolution, overall better your end image will look, sharper. But it also requires a lot more power and time to create a higher resolution image. A good balance here would be to stick with around 1080 pixels for your smaller dimension. Just like you can see in my example, width is set to 1080 pixels. Now for the Progressive Rendering tab. Basically here you set for how long do you render your image. You can even set exact time in seconds. But mostly people use the max samples option to regulate everything. More samples equals to longer renders, but with less noise. Mine render is set for 500 samples, which is not a lot but fine for this tutorial. More about progressive rendering you can learn in our other video devoted to the rendering settings. some additional minor thing can be done in the Optimization tab. Here it is possible to change the instancing optimization to speed. I am not sure how much does it actually impact the speed, but each small bit helps, so why not? Next goes the Filtering tab. This one is important, as there are some things that can drastically improve on the time. Starting with the Firefly filter. It can be tempting to turn it off to save some time, but I strongly don't recommend you to do that. Mainly because the drawback of doing so is too strong. Adding fireflies to your image is a bad idea. On the other hand, post-denoising is what's going to really help us. What it does is gets rid of the noise and the cost of the image sharpness. So your images will be a bit smoother, but there would be far less noise. This means that I can afford lowering the overall amount of samples. And this would be compensated with the denoiser. One more thing that is vital for faster renders is your lighting. Right now my scene has 3 individual spotlights. Your computer will need to process each light source when you are rendering. So more spotlights equals to longer renders. Let's delete all 3 of them and use an HDRI instead. To use an HDRI, you need to open an Environment tab. And change your environment mode to either Dome or Dome and Scene. Then click on the Environment map and select an image from your computer. As you can see, I already have an image ready here. After I render it, we can see that the image is a bit dark. This is a problem, because brighter scenes tend to render quite faster and with less noise. Change the environment intensity to 2 to make everything brighter. And let's produce the final render. This is the final render. Lighting changed, but overall I would say that it is even better than an initial one. Most importantly, we need to check rendering times. Did it render faster? The final time is 2 minutes and almost 17 seconds. Which is more than 2 minutes faster than the initial time. 53% faster to be exact. I think it is a great result. But it can go even further with other minor things that you can find out yourself. For example, adding depth of field and using smaller texture sizes can lower render times even more. Also, oversampling. It is a process when you increase the resolution of your render, but don't touch the amount of samples. Render it and then use third-party software to compress the picture back to the original resolution. Presumably, this gets rid of the noise and is faster than simply increasing the samples amount. But I did not test this enough. So can't guarantee good results. Also, always check which part of your scene are not in the frame of your camera. You can hide parts like this and it can improve on the time. Because even if they are not directly in the frame, they can still influence the scene. For example, on my scene I have deleted the roof and can also hide basically everything that is on the right side, because I am only rendering the left part. When I return to the camera view, it is as if nothing has changed. Lastly, don't forget to always make a test render with small samples amount. Even if you are sure that your render should be good, still produce a test one. If later you notice some minor problem in your final render, you either would be left with it or will be forced to redo the render. So double checking your test render can save you a lot of your time in the future. One more thing that is important to know is that there are products on the DAWS 3DCOM shop that will help you. For example, we talked how each spotlight increases rendering time. Instead of deleting them, you can try to replace them with something less taxing. Like iRay Ghost Kit. It is a set of volumetric lights that are cheaper to render than built-in lights. Or we just talked how it is important to hide everything that you don't need from the scene. Instead of doing this manually each time, you can just use the iRay Stand Kit. Using it, you can set the boundaries and everything outside of them would be hidden on your render. Easily decreasing rendering times. And of course, we can't talk about making your renders faster without mentioning Scene Optimizer. It is a set of tools that will automatically optimize your scenes. Additionally to making render times that much faster, optimizations also drastically decrease the amount of RAM that is needed for render. At the same time, renders look as if nothing has changed at all. To learn more about renders and how to make them faster, check links to our articles about this in the description. Or check our channel, we have a render settings explained video ready for you. This video is based on our DAWS 3D Faster Render Tips article, where you can find even more ways to speed up your renders. All links in the description. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more inspiration.